master electrician role here at Sight and Sound Theaters encompasses many different aspects of this JONAH show build process. After working closely with the lighting designer, getting a feel and insight for the show, we will then take a look at Art and Media's concept sketches for each scene, looking at sets specifically to see where we can put some lights in sets so that we can feature the actors on stage. Once the lighting designer is finished with the lighting plot, which is basically a roadmap for where the lights are placed on stage, I will then circuit each of those lights and give them a dimmer so that they can be brought up in intensity and down in intensity on stage. Included in that finalized plot are automated lights. These automated lights are just fancy lights that move and change color and add images on their own. These fixtures need to be programmed in the console for us to manipulate them back at the lighting control room. Once I assign the fixtures appropriate dimmers and the automated lights are set up in the console, then I'll go back to the CAD software and make sure that each light has a cable represented for it. Now these cables will power the lights and will give the data that talks to the moving lights. For JONAH, we'll have over 6 miles of cable used for the show. Once all the setup is complete for the automated lights and the conventional fixtures, the lighting designer and I will sit down at the console and get some predetermined looks together on our CAD software, which is a virtual environment where the lights react to the stage and the sets that are on the stage. From there, we can take that show up to the lighting control room once the lighting rig is hung and program the lights in their intended environment. For the JONAH process, we've already completed the lighting plot, assigned dimmers, and patched the console. And now we're ready to see how the lights react to the sets, the actors, and the seamless transitions on stage during the JONAH rehearsal process.